So thank you all for joining. This is the penultimate Applied PD seminar at the University of Washington for this academic year. Our speaker today is Igor Rumanov. Igor got his PhD in 2010 from University of California, Davis under the direction of Craig Tracy. And since then, he's had a number of postdoctoral positions, as I understand it, both in Boulder, Colorado, where he's switched departments, and he's now working in the Applied Math Department with Mark Ablitz and also Justin Cole. And today he'll tell us about 2+1 dimensional WIDM systems, 2D NLS, KP, and others. Thank you, Igor.
Yeah, thank you very much for the invitation. I'm glad to give my talk here. The main result that I will talk about will be about this 2+1 dimensional nonlinear Schrödinger equation and the WIDM system related to it. This is the joint work with Mark Ablitz and Justin Cole did. And the rest will be my thoughts about this 2+1 dimensional and 1+1 dimensional WIDM systems and what would be good to do about their solutions. This is partly in progress, partly just wishes what has to be done in my view. And okay. So let me start. So what I yes, so there are various types of systems which should be somehow considered inside some general picture to be developed yet. There are so-called dispersionless hydrodynamic systems. And on the other hand, there are so-called WIDM modulation systems, which arise as small dispersion limits in various equations, often very well known and important equations like KdV, NLS, and now for 2+1 dimensional equations like KP and 2D NLS and some others, such systems appeared in recent years. So this is one kind of distinction, which is important, dispersionless systems versus kind of infinitesimally small, but still non-zero dispersion limit of equations. yeah, and of course, there is a big difference between this 1+1 dimensional systems and 2+1 dimensional systems. Well, this is some of what I'm going to talk about. So in one dimensions, we basically, in one spatial dimension, we usually get the systems which can be diagonalized this or that way. And then we get the systems in terms of so-called Riemann invariants or Riemann variables. They have this form like dt rj plus vj dx rj equals zero, where j goes over some number of, which is the number of such Riemann variables, and vj are certain hydrodynamic velocities, which are themselves are certain functions of this Riemann variables rj. And then for systems like this, the general method of obtaining at least local solutions was developed by Tsarev, starting in 1985, then somewhat developed further in 1990. The solutions, the general local solutions, at least they have this form of hodograph solutions of the form X minus VIT equal to WI, where WI are again some functions of variables RJ, which are in principle determined by various initial conditions. But that is in general tricky, and it's kind of going here from local solutions to the global solutions is one of the problems, which is in general, as far as I know, not settled at all. And besides, WI are not. Not arbitrary, they not just determined by initial conditions, they also must satisfy certain Tsarev compatibility conditions, which have this form. Here the derivatives dj mean the derivative with respect to the corresponding rj variable. Yeah, so this is something to remember about 1+1 dimensional systems. As for the 2+1 dimensional systems, so they are not like this, Yeah, so the important example, and actually the first example of 2+1 dimensional rhythm system is the KP rhythm system, which was derived as a small dispersion limit of the Kadamtsev-Petriashvili, or in short KP equation. It was done first in 2016 by Ablowitz, Biondini, Mark Ablowitz, Gina Biondini, Wang was student of Biondini at the time. And this system, unfortunately, is not completely diagonalizable, and that concerns all so far known 2+1 dimensional rhythm systems. So this system, basically, it contains this five equations. There are three equations for three RJ variables. And these RJ variables are totally analogous to the complete analogs of the KdV Riemann invariants. However, there are, as you see here, in equations for these variables, besides this generalized hydrodynamic velocities multiplying the x derivatives, there are also additional terms involving pi derivatives. Here capital dy is this operator, a convective dy derivative, which is dy minus q dx. Q, by the way, is the slope, it's the ratio of the wave vector in the y direction to the one in the x direction. That's the meaning of q variable here. And q itself satisfies this dynamical equation. And there is one more variable. So there are a total of five variables here. The three RJ variables, q variable, and another variable, p variable. And the p variable here satisfies only this non-dynamical equation. There is no time derivative in P. This is related to the non-evolutionary nature of KP itself. other notations are here. The capital V is the, up to the constant, which depends on the normalization as the sum of Rj variables, and the hydrodynamic velocities are the KdV with them velocities, which of course are relevant for Kp for similar reasons. And they have the form capital V plus 2 over Djk over k, and jk over k are the log derivatives with respect to Rj variables of the wave vector. So this I explicitly can be expressed in terms of Rj, and these expressions involve the ratio of second and first complete elliptic integrals of the so-called elliptic modulus, which is itself the, in terms of R variables, the ratio of the R differences. And besides, there is a constraint and another non-dynamical equation, which is basically comes from the definitions of Q and K. And this basically says that dx Q is equal to the convective derivative of the log K here. So this is the KP rhythm system, and now I will talk about the 2+1-dimensional nonlinear Schrödinger equation, which has this form. This epsilon parameter here is the dispersion parameter, dimensionless dispersion parameter, which will be considered to be small, and we will consider the limit as epsilon goes to zero. And here the sign S has the meaning of the sign distinguishing the elliptic case of this 2D NLS equation from the hyperbolic case. The elliptic cases when S is plus one, then you see the you have dxx plus dyy, and S equal to minus one is the case of the hyperbolic, so-called hyperbolic to the NLS equation, when we have dxx minus dy. Well, for the elliptic case, this equation as it's written is the defocusing two-dimensional NLS equation. And for the hyperbolic case, of course, it's focusing in one direction and defocusing in the other. Well, this this equation has wide set of applications for deep water waves with surface tension. It often appears, especially the hyperbolic case, the elliptic case is very important equation for Bose-Einstein condensate wave functions in certain geometries, especially like there are many experiments in cylindric geometries where, not much depends on the z direction, and all the dynamics is playing in the perpendicular xy plane. And then this 2+1 equation is a good approximation. Also, the raises is an approximation in certain cases in plasma physics, nonlinear optics, magnetics, many others. And so we will consider here the small dispersion limit of this equation, which alternatively, by the way, can be thought of or can be viewed as a limit of large amplitudes. It's kind of duality of pictures here. Small dispersion is for this type of equation is in a sense same as considering large amplitude and other one dispersion. But this is just a parenthetic remark. So the procedure here and similar kind of procedure applies to the derivation of KP rhythm system. Here, this is somewhat more complicated. So this psi function is a complex object. Can be written using the Madelung transformation in terms of the square root of the in terms of the amplitude which is the square root of amplitude squared. This rho variable is a density type variable in the corresponding hydrodynamic picture times the exponent of I times this capital theta, which is the phase, total phase of the wave function. And those functions, they depend on the fast phase variable, which is a feature of all type of rhythm systems. There could be more than one such variable, but we consider here the case of just one fast phase. This is the simplest, and actually for many applications the most important case, and actually it's well known that long time dynamics of the rhythm systems with several phases often reduces at long time to the one phase solutions. So the one phase solutions have, from many points of view, a special significance. And besides the fast phase depends on slow variables, which are the already introduced spatial xy variables and time t variables. Depends on small dispersion epsilon, and the fast phase the derivatives of fast phase are actually important. Dx derivative, which is a wave vector in x direction k divided by epsilon, it's large, and divide derivative is wave vector y direction l divided by epsilon. Time derivative is minus frequency over epsilon, and then this the introduction of these variables immediately leads to the kinematic relations between them, which are just consequences of the fact that they are various partial derivatives of this fast phase. You have this kinematic relations and introduces this slope variable q l over k, which I already talked about in application to KP rhythm system. This can be written in this form, where we have this two dynamical equation for k and q, and this this is the constraint dxq equal to the convective derivative of log k, similarly to the in this respect, similarly to what we have for the KP. So this part is actually similar for all two plus one dimensional system. The other rhythm equations can be derived in various approaches, and the approach that we used here is the approach of expansion in the small dispersion, this WKB type expansion, and then they using the periodicity in the fast phase theta, little theta, and then the other rhythm equations arises from the required periodicity in theta as so-called singularity conditions, and then important variables here are also the velocities, hydrodynamic material velocities, so to say, which are defined as the spatial derivatives of the total phase, capital theta of the wave function. And then complex 2D NLS equation can be written as split in terms of real and imaginary part, and the imaginary part gives the density conservation law, and the real part can be written like this. And what really for many purposes is sufficient is to consider the corresponding equations for the derivatives u and v of the capital theta, so the hydrodynamic velocity equations. And well, these u and v variables again are not independent, since they are derivative of the same total phase, then they satisfy this constraint dxv equal to dy u here, which also plays an important role in all considerations. Well, then the epsilon expansion goes as follows. We expand this variables rho u and v like this, the leading order contributions plus epsilon times first order contributions plus further terms of order epsilon square, which we will neglect. And then the constraint dxv equal to dy u, it leads to the following relation for the leading v and u variables. Leading variable v naught is related to the leading variable u naught in this way, as q u naught plus p. And this p is this additional slow variable which is basically introduced from this relation. And this is how it enters into the picture for the KP rhythm system and for basically virtually all such 2 plus 1 dimensional systems. Well, then, considering the leading order here, then the from the density leading order of the density conservation, we get the relation between the u naught variable and the rho naught variable. It is actually convenient here for the 2 plus 1 dimensional NLS to introduce another leading order variable, which I call mu naught, which is related to rho naught in this way. It's 1 plus rho naught is 1 plus s q squared mu naught. Then it turns out that that mu naught is satisfies the elliptic ordinary differential equation in terms of fast phase of the same form as the leading order of the one dimensional NLS equation. So mu naught is the completely similar to the density of the one dimensional NLS equation. That's the purpose of this transformation. Then also the variables we get the relation instead of the frequency omega, it is convenient to use the capital V variable, which is related in this more complicated way to omega in this case, unlike the one-dimensional NLS case where we would have just that omega would be equal to kV. Here the relation is different, and also it's convenient to use this corresponding velocity in y direction, which is v sub y. It's not a derivative, it's just a notation to distinguish it from capital V. introduced this way. And then the complete rhythm system, complete rhythm system for this 2D NLS case can be presented in this way. It's here. We have these two kinematic equations for the K and Q, just written in terms of this V and VY variables instead of using omega. And then we have this circularity equations. One is the averaging of the leading order, this come at the order epsilon as averaging with respect to fast phase theta of the of the first order in epsilon equations. The equations there are some terms contained in total derivative in fast phase, and those and the averages and the averaging go away, and what remains are those conservation laws in terms of slow variables, and there is a density conservation law here. One can introduce and use the momentum conservation laws for the first component of the momentum, and for x component, and for the y component. And besides, the most complicated equation is the averaged energy equation. So here we have this total of six dynamical rhythm equations, and besides there are these two constraints, the non-dynamical equations, the origin of which I have already shown. written like this, so the total is this eight equations, and then again, like in KP case, the system cannot be completely diagonalized, but it can be expressed in terms of basically one-dimensional NLS Riemann variables, which are related, introduced the same way as for the one-dimensional NLS in terms of the capital V variable and the lambda variables, which are roots of the cubic entry in the elliptic leading order solution for the one-dimensional NLS, and then the hydrodynamic velocities are they are related again with the uh, with the log derivative of vector k. Sorry, there is a typo here that should be 1/4 log derivative here instead of this quantity being in the numerator. And the log derivatives, again, they related to the expressed explicitly in terms of R variables. four of the subset of these equations, the four equations, namely the equations that I introduced before, they can be combined so that a set of four equations can be extracted and expressed in terms of the corresponding R variables, and these four equations can be brought to this form where we have this generalized time derivatives involving this capital D operator and generalized X variables involving this generalized dx operator and this capital dy, the convective derivative operator, and so this can be written in this form or equivalently in this form after the multiplying by inverse of the van der Mond matrix involving the R variables. And those WJ terms here, they basically can be written as involving only these dy convective derivatives. And so that this is the apparently the best which can be done here in terms of diagonalization analogous to the diagonalization for one-dimensional systems, and then we get the corresponding system in terms of Riemann variables. We have this four equations for the 1D NLS, so to say, Riemann variables. They have this form where this additional HJ terms, they are pretty complicated. They explicitly are written out here, and you see they involve this convective dy derivatives, but also dxq and dxp derivatives. But remember, those can be written by the constraint equations. This also can be written as convective dy derivatives. These are four of the system. Remember, there was total of eight equations, and the rest are those. And these are just the dynamical. There are these dynamical Q and P equations written in terms of Q, P, and the RJ variables. Here, capital V is the sum of RJ variables. The quantity capital R2 is the sum of the R squares. Quantity G is 1 plus SQ squared. Besides these two dynamical equations and previous four dynamical equations, there are these constraints which also can be written in terms of Q, P, and R variables. So this is the So total here again there are six dynamical equations and two constraints for six dependent variables. Well, the system is pretty complicated, so it's good to have some results about it, which can be compared to what exists in literature. And here, one of such is the analysis of the linear stability of the traveling wave solutions. So we consider the traveling wave solutions, which are leading order solutions propagating in the x direction. And then for such solutions, the leading order for the Vedum variables are constant Vedum solutions, where since we propagate along the x direction, the Riemann variables can be written as a constant solution plus the plus a perturbation, which is periodic in x, y, and t, and rho j it's small amplitudes, and the q and p variables, since we propagate in the x direction, their leading order is zero, and so they have just this first order contribution, which are also considered to be periodic, and the eta and nu are the corresponding small amplitudes. And the kappa, L, and omega now have the meaning of the corresponding wave vectors and frequency of this periodic perturbations, and we consider the stability of such periodic perturbations, and then six say dynamical equations can be written. They linearize in terms of those small amplitudes rho j, eta, and nu, and require this form where j is the notation. It depends on explicitly. It's more complicated. It depends on the constant leading order quantities, and then the then we get the linear homogeneous algebraic six by six system for the six perturbation amplitudes, and it's solvable when its determinant is equal to zero. And this gives the dispersion relation for the perturbations omega in terms of wave vectors, and here the if we take L the transverse wave vector to be zero, then everything becomes is very simple. You see that all the longitudinal linear perturbations here are stable, pretty trivially, and the most interesting case is subcase of this dispersion relation is the transverse stability when the longitudinal wave vector of perturbations kappa is zero, and then we get the following the dispersion relation reduces to this equation, which is omega squared factors out, and so we have these two trivial nodes, and besides that we have a quadratic equation, quadratic algebraic equation for omega squared. Actually it's equation for this variable, for omega squared divided by s l squared, And so the solutions can be written in terms of quadratic formula, where the terms in the quadratic formula are related to the previous coefficients in the equations which depend on the constant parameters. So that we see from here that if the corresponding mode for the elliptic case has omega squared has certain sign. If it is real, then the corresponding mode for the hyperbolic case has omega squared has the opposite sign. So that if the corresponding mode for the elliptic case is stable, then it is unstable for the hyperbolic case, and vice versa. this is obvious, and this kind of relation it was kind of seen and derived before by different methods, not using this complete rhythm theory, using in particular direct perturbations, and as John Carter did, starting with his PhD thesis back in 2001. In this respect, we confirming here his and other people's results. And this is what we get. It's like from the from the rhythm theory and in comparison with the direct numerics also. We have this two modes for omega squared. So one corresponds to the plus sign in the previous equation, and the other corresponds to the minus sign. And we see that one of them is always positive, and the other is always negative. This is here what is plotted here is the dependence of this quantity omega squared over SL squared as a function of M for various fixed values of the other parameters. You see, we represent this four constant R parameters of the leading solution as in this form. One of the true important parameters is the elliptic modulus, and this is what is on the x-axis here on these pictures. And the other parameter corresponds to each curve here. It's different for each curve, and it's basically can be thought of as some kind of amplitude parameter. It's introduced in such a way so that it is related to the certain amplitude for DSW type solutions, although here, of course, we consider the stability of just traveling wave non-modulated solutions. And the other two parameters can be always fixed by in various ways by translation and scale scaling transformations. In these pictures, the different curves correspond to different values of this B parameter, and colored continuous curves correspond to the result of the rhythm theory formula, and the dashed curves correspond to the to the direct numerics. So this is a very good comparison, and here we also basically are confirming by other methods the results which are known. We confirm the the algorithm theory here by getting these results for the stability of traveling waves, which were known by calculations of stability of Carter and other people in particular, and Bernard DeConnick was also a collaborator of Carter, and I forgot there was the third after they also considered this kind of stabilities for wide ranges of parameters. Mm. Well, it's interesting also to consider how this stability develops, and that is very different for the two cases. For the case of hyperbolic equation, the development of the so we see from those pictures that there are always unstable modes for both for hyperbolic and elliptic cases, and the development of transverse instability for the hyperbolic case it leads to this neck kind of instability when it's like this higher frequency modes radiate from central peak after the neck is formed. So here, this is explicit initial condition that we used. We used this initial traveling wave traveling in the x direction and the transverse perturbation in y direction, and so that have this kind of picture. And for the elliptic case, it leads to the development of another type of instability, snake instability, which is this kind of snake appears, and then further development leads to kind of breaking of the snakes into what are known to be related to the vortex anti-vortex pairs. This is the phenomenon known for the elliptic 2D NLS equation. So indeed, these are the nice direct numerics which are confirmed here, many results which are known before in our consideration. Well, this is just for reference. This is the kind of traveling wave solution whose stability we considered here. Explicit form of it involving the R parameters. yeah, there are. Yeah, these are the special case, some special cases of it involve the linear simple phase solutions, which in terms of our parameters happen when the smallest root of the cubic is zero. In terms of our substantial parameters, M and B, such solutions occur when B is greater or equal than four. They have this form in terms of M and B. And another special case is when is the solitonic limit when M parameters goes to zero and these are also known solutions, and when the, these two curves intersect in the parameter plane of M and B, then we have black solitons with linear phase, and this is known to be related to vortex formation. Well, again, this is a sort of a side remark, and well, now I want to mention that the 2D NLS equation is very rich and complicated, and it is known to have many interesting non-trivial limits, which are these are some of the important known reductions of two-dimensional NLS equation. One of them is the KP equation. Then another known reduction is 2 plus 1 dimensional Boussinesq equation, important in water waves theory. The KP equation is known to be integrable, while the 2 plus 1 dimension Boussinesq equation is not, as well as 2 plus 1 dimensional NLS itself. And then the another reduction is the radial cylindrical KP equation. Then also a reduction is the Davis-Tjordson equation, another integrable reduction. Then we have various solitonic harmonic and simple phase limit, and also various 1 plus 1 reductions of the above. And all of these reductions lead to the corresponding important rhythm systems. Here I only briefly consider the reduction to the KP equation, and this reduction of the original equation itself was known for a long time, since at least the work of Kuznetsov and Turitsin in 1988, who by the way considered the stability of 2D NLS dark solitons using the KP theory, actually by using this limit. And so it goes like this: one can use the corresponding scalings of variables. There is a shift in X variable. There is a certain traveling velocity which is related to the this is a sound type velocity which is related to the background density of the Bose condensate, and not if you consider it an application to the Bose condensate. The other variables are scaling differently. Here we introduced the additional scaling parameter delta, which is small and which is unrelated to the small dispersion parameter. It's independent of it. And then we have, using the Madelung transformation, we have the corresponding scalings for the density, its leading order, this and not, which I already mentioned. And then we have next terms at order delta squared. And for the total phase, we have this large amplitude, which is 1 over delta squared. And the next term, which is really important, is proportional to delta. And the hydrodynamic velocities, they have corresponding delta squared terms and delta cubed terms as leading orders. And then both this U-naught variable and N1 variable, which is proportional to U-naught, and C is the constant of proportionality. So both of them satisfy the corresponding KP equation, which is written, can be written in the following form. And so we get here the KP1 equation for the elliptic case and KP2 equation for the hyperbolic case. This naturally leads to the corresponding scalings for the kinematic variables and the kinematic equations under this scaling take the corresponding KP form. So KK squares as delta, scales as delta, Q as delta, and then the P variables turned out to scale as delta cube. And then the R Riemann variables, they scale in the following way as leading order constant values plus delta square times certain quantities which are related to the corresponding KP variables. And this background constants are different here. Three of them are equal, and the corresponding rho J variable then lead to the corresponding KP R variables, and the other constant the other constant is different, so it's kind of this R variables splits this way from the other three, and this the corresponding correction to it is related to the Q variable, the slope variable, and then we get the corresponding rhythm KP equations, except for one feature that when we start with the dynamical equation for the P variable, it would be very nice to get the corresponding closed dynamical equation for the KP rhythm system. And originally from the beginning, what could try to hope that that could this could be possible. But unfortunately, one is frustrated when one does the calculation. It turns out that this equation leads to the necessity of including the terms of higher order in delta. So this equation this way cannot be closed. If you consider next orders in delta, then we get more variables, and this way we cannot get a closed system. So that unfortunately for the KP rhythm system, we are still have to be content with the closed system, which was known previously. Well, guess I'm getting practically out of time. So what I wanted to tell about, but probably will not have time, is that the dispersionless systems, they are obtained often as certain limits, in particular as solitonic and harmonic limits of the corresponding complete rhythm systems. And this is true both of the 1+1 and 2+1 dimensional systems. And then the theory of hydrodynamic dispersionless equations is well developed, and there is a nice picture of it, which I do not have time to tell about, which relates it to conformal maps and to so-called Loebner equations. This is known for the equations related to the dispersionless KP equation. But so for those conformal maps, nice solutions can be related, but it's a big open question how to relate the solutions of the complete rhythm systems to those to those types of complex solutions, and also to relate the 2+1 equations and solutions to the hodograph type solutions related to the 1+1 dimensional case. Yeah, so one of the ways here that can be developed for the at least for the integrable two plus one dimensional systems, which is considering the hydrodynamic reductions, where the derivatives equations involving x, y, and t derivatives split into the equations involving only x, y derivatives and respectively only x, t derivatives. And then for such reductions, this kind of Loebner equations theory and the theory of conformal maps can be developed, and there is a conjecture which was put forward by Ferapontov and Husnutdinova that at least for the in 2004 that at least for the hydrodynamic integrable two plus one dimensional systems, they always can be represented as such reductions, such combinations of one dimensional type reductions. And for the two component systems, it was shown by them substantially to be equivalent to having dispersionless Lux pair to equivalent to the integrability. Well, similar kind of consideration is possible to continue for the dispersionless, sorry, for the full Wiedemann KP system, which is a work in progress. And well, I believe there is more to discover along this path, and it's a very interesting and exciting problem to relate the known Wiedemann systems to the all the interesting methods and solutions which were developed for the dispersionless type of systems, which they are a priori related, but different from. Okay, I probably should stop here. I'm sorry, I'm out of time already. So thank you for your attention.